Here on East New York, a man out on bond for previous criminal cases allegedly pointed a rifle at an IMPD officer this month. Police quickly arrested Dante Swinton, who was then released from jail on a low-level bond before being rearrested.
That shows an individual that is clearly a threat to the public that needs to be charged federally.
U.S. Attorney Josh Minkler did just that and filed federal firearm charges against Swinton in two other federal cases. An interstate traffic stop led to federal drug and gun charges against a man named Donald Rudolph, and this man, Dorian Hayden, has been charged federally after police claim they found 3.5 pounds of meth during a raid on his home.
We've made it very clear that the days of us not taking these cases are over.
We recognize that interventions must take place. Something must be done to curtail violence and violent crime in our community.
Still, Tony Mason with the Indianapolis Urban League tells me he's concerned the federal program will focus too heavily on minority neighborhoods while not addressing the root causes of violence.
And so our concern with Project Safe Neighborhoods is ultimately, history has shown us that efforts like this lead to racial profiling.
Last year, Project Safe Neighborhood resulted in 220 federal cases being filed, nearly the same number as 2018, all with the same message.
Make no mistake about it, the consequences for committing a federal crime are harsh. Because if you're caught federally, you will be detained, you will be prosecuted fully, and you will be sent to federal prison.
Jesse Wells, Fox 59 News.